And once again, hang time. Hall. The elevation.
Kicks back on goal. That's a magical snap from Ray Danilo.
He kicks towards the forward pocket. Mark's taken.
Good carry. It has.
Welcome to episode 11 of AFT here from Patterson Stadium. A wet and blustery day for us today, Dave. Severe weather warnings, but we'll battle on.
Yeah, it's been very, very wet, hasn't it? In fact, I think the West Coast Eagles cancelled their training session. Yeah. No good for us. We have to go out in the rain. Well,
we had to walk up the stairs.
So we're hammering on.
We always do, mate, as did the players on the weekend. Another great round of football, a few close games, a few upsets. So let's get straight into today and have a look at the first game now. Trinity Aquinas 9-10-64 defeating University 9-9-63. We talked about the close games. 1 point, you don't get much closer than that.
Yeah, this was, could have gone either way. We spoke about that last week. But TA, they're now one of the form teams of the competition, and they've continued Uni's, horror run over the past month and a bit. Dave Crawford and Cam Neville kicked 2 goals each for the victors. And, of course, that is 5 losses in 6 games now, I think, for University. They're in a bit of strife, and of course that puts TA into the 5.
We're talking about strife. It doesn't get much worse for Swan Athletic. They went down to Whitford's on the weekend, 13-3-81 to 6-11-47. Where does this leave their season?
Well, they're a bit of strife now, aren't they? 34-point win there to the Warriors boys. We've said this could have gone either way, but Whitford's have shown a bit over late. Unfortunately, Swan haven't. And that's now leaving them 2 games clear at the bottom, and they've got a really huge, massive fight on their hands to stay out of that drop zone.
Yeah, disappointing there. If the competition wasn't scared before, they are now. Fremantle CBC giving it to North Beach, 16-14-110 to 10-6-66.
Well, I don't think this result, Adam, is a surprise, more than the actual amount they won by. 44 points, it's a fair old flogging against the side North Beach. They were up and running over the last couple of weeks. They went in with some good form. We actually thought they might actually give CBC a run for their money. But 44 points, that's a big win to what is the running away league leaders, Matthew Lesse. Apologies if I pronounced that incorrectly. 4 goals, Josh Vinci, 3 as well for Frio CBC. They're just unstoppable, mate.
They've been playing very good football. A bit of an upset the next game. Kalamunda getting over the top of Mount Lawley to stop their rich reign of former of late. 13-7-85 to 10-9-69. Doesn't this just throw up a little mix in the table?
It does a bit. And I think maybe they've had some personnel issues up there in Cougarland over time. Maybe they've got a few boys back. But one boy that was humming for the Cougars was Stevie Armstrong, premiership player with the West Coast, of course. He's hit the scoreboard with a good return of 5 goals, and that keeps the Cougars' finals hopes slightly alive, the door slightly ajar for them. And I think it's a good win for them because they've shown some early in the season. They've just got off the tracks of late, but a good win to help them get back on the rails.
And some inaccurate kicking didn't cost Wesley Curtin, 9-14-68 defeating West Coast 7-3-45.
Yeah, very inaccurate kicking, Wesley Curtin. Second game we've seen of them down at their home park, and it's the second time that we've been there that they've actually struggled to kick goals. 23-point win, that's probably a little favourable to West Coast, who were pretty much outplayed for large portions of this match. As you see, 19-14 against 7-3. That's a big differential in the number of shots on goal. West Coast, at times when they went forward, they used the ball well. They had limited opportunities going forward, but when they got inside 50, they managed to take marks, as we see here on the highlights, and kick goals. So those three behinds, two of those were rushed. So they only missed 1 shot at goal all day, Adam. So there's very congested footy. Wasn't exactly a standout game. It was congested, especially in Wesley Curtin's forward half, where the ball remained for large portions of the game. West Coast just struggled to get it beyond halfway at times. They really lacked that link-up play. He was a standout, Ashley Fitzgerald. This bloke, I tell you what, he's going to be a superstar. Not much of him, but he is, I reckon, one of the quickest blokes in the competition. His speed, and he plays in the forward line, is just unstoppable. And he put the afterburners on several occasions and ran opponents ragged, but his kicking was a little bit wayward. He actually took about 5 or 6 shots on goal to finally get his first late in the game, but he was a standout. And it's just another good win to the second-placed Wesley Curtin defending premiers.
Yeah, let's hear now from Marcus Ayres and also Earl Sporting.
Okay, well, I'm here with Wesley Curtin coach Earl Sporting. And Earl, the boys didn't have it all their own way, but you must be pretty happy to get the win.
Yeah, we made a lot of mistakes and turned the ball over, and look, so did they. There's a bit of pressure on, and in the end, you know, both teams were out on their feet, so obviously worked pretty hard and not used to the warm weather of today. Not that it was that hot, but you know, what we've been going through. So, I mean, it was a pretty ugly, scrappy game, so we're happy to sort of come away with the 4 points because they're pretty important this time of year.
Okay, and with West Coast Cowan coach Marcus Ayres, and Marcus, the boys were in that for a long time, they just couldn't quite get there.
No, we've let ourselves down all this year just with our consistency, and you know, we're good enough when we decide to play. We've just got to get the consistency part right, and we're taking all the top teams to to near the finish line, but just haven't been able to get there. So,
and I guess to limit, after they kicked four goals in the first quarter, to limit them to three after that, was that sort of, I guess, a testament to a better defensive showing?
Oh, yeah, look, probably. We starved them of opportunities. I think we had double inside 50s to them, and we didn't make the most of our opportunities. And our defence hung in there. They probably got beaten one-on-one in the first quarter, but hung in there after that, competed pretty well.
You know, can you take something out of this result, even though it was a loss, and, you know, you don't want to say honourable loss, but, you know, you must feel like there's something that the players can take out of that, because when they were on today, they were on.
Yeah, no, you know, to have the amount of blokes we got out at the moment, and to have the guys come up from our twos are struggling a bit,
yep,
and to see them stand up and show the growth and the potential, then, it is positive, and that's what I said to the boys inside. It's a positive situation, but, you know, you still got to remember that we didn't win. We've got to get better, so we'll just keep working on improving.
Great to hear from both coaches there. Let's have a look at the ladder now, and as we've seen throughout the season, a loss can mean a lot. A win can even put you in the five, and there's a few sides now that might just be surprised at where they're sitting. If we have a look there on the screen, Fremantle CVC, still only the one loss for the season. They're two games clear of Wesley Curtin. University, they're two games behind Wesley Curtin in third, and then we've got North Beach, TAs, Mount Lawley. It's a big bundle there between third to sixth. Kalamunda, they get their fifth win of the season, then West Coast, Whitford and Swanath down the bottom with only one win. How do you see the ladder now, Dave?
Well, as you mentioned, Adam, one loss or one result that doesn't go your way affects you heading into these last few games of the season. And as we see, Mount Lawley, we've been talking about them for a couple of weeks, on the rise for one game, just lose one game. They were on a winning streak of about five games, one game, and all of a sudden they're outside of the five. So there's going to be a huge battle on for those final placings. And I think what the ladder says also is that Wesley Curtin probably now, realistically, is the only team that could potentially catch CBC Freo in top spot, if you were game enough to perhaps put some money on CBC dropping some games. But when you've got a four-game gap between first and third, you'd suggest that those top two spots at the moment, Wesley Curtin, the defending premiers, and CBC Freo, they've got a mortgage on those two at the moment.
Yeah, one and two looking very nice, but as we said, very clustered in the middle there. Let's have a look at the next round now, just to see if any of these sides can start putting a bit of a buffer or try to take some games off each other. The first game we'll look at, West Coast sitting in eighth, take on TA sitting in fifth. As you said earlier, TAs are showing a little bit of form. How do you expect this one to go?
Well, I would expect TAs to win this one. They are a bit of one of the form teams of the comp at the moment. They've strung about three games together, which is fantastic. So you'd expect another win to them. But West Coast, they want to keep their very, very, very slim finals hopes alive. And I think I mentioned last week, there's now only one game between them and Whitford's, and Whitford's will be chasing their tail pretty hard to stay out of that drop zone. So West Coast still have to keep winning to make sure they don't get in that bottom two.
In the next game, Swanath take on Kalamunda. We saw Kalamunda turn back the clock and bounce back into some form against Mount Lawley last week. Do you think they just get past Swanath?
I haven't been fairly forthright, I think, this year, but I'm going to be fairly forthright. I reckon Kalamunda will absolutely towel up Swan on the weekend. I think they'll get absolutely spanked. Swan's really struggling defensively and also to kick goals. And although the Cougars' defence hasn't been great, they're a really potently offensive side, especially with the likes of Stevie Armstrong running wild. And I would expect, if he plays on the weekend, to perhaps kick another bag.
Well, as we said, Mount Lawley were the form team of the competition. They went down on the weekend, but they'll be hoping to bounce back this weekend against Fremantle CBC. Only the one loss for the season. Can they make it two?
Tough to pick this one. I mean, each week we back in, or we jeer up the team that's going to play CBC and do it again this week. I guess it's on the Hawks home park, so you give them maybe an extra foot in the door in that regard. But they've got to really shut down the CBC midfield. It'll be a tough one.
North Beach taking on Wesley Curtin. Looks to be another good match, and again, North Beach would want to bounce back.
Yeah, North Beach were fairly, well, they were disappointing against CBC Freo. We thought they might give a good showing there, but to go down by 44 points is a fair old hammering. Wesley Curtin, they did get a win over West Coast, but they weren't that impressive. Maybe throw a blanket over this one. North Beach, like we said, good running young side. They could take it to the premiers.
The last game of the round that we'll have a look at, University take on Whitfords. And if you just look at ladder position, you'd say this is going to be an easy win. But one thing we've learnt from Whitfords all year is that they can compete with every side.
Well, we saw this this corresponding fixture earlier in the year, Adam, where Uni went to Whitford. And it was at that stage last v first. And we expected it to go Uni's way, which it did. However, up till half time, I think there was only about 5 points in it until Uni came out and kicked 7-odd goals in a row in the third term. Whitford's get them at a good time. They're coming off a win, a good solid win against Swans, so they've got a bit of confidence behind them. And Uni, well, we keep talking about them. They're I don't know what's going on down there at UWA land. They're just in a bit of strife. So. Well, we can see what happens. I expect that Uni would win this, but if you're going to have any time to take on Uni, now's the time, I guess.
Well, Dave, normally we do get the chance to speak to a coach, a captain, or one of the players, but we are at Paterson Stadium today, so we're going to go even better. We're going to talk to the general manager of the WAFL.
The man that pays the bills.
Looking forward to it. I better be careful. Looking forward to speaking to David Armstrong right now. David, thank you for joining us on this wet day. Bit cold behind us.
It is a bit cold, but that's winter when you play football.
It certainly is, and the football has been pretty good this season. A close competition with upsets each round. You'd be pretty happy with the performances of most of the sides.
Although we've been really happy with the clubs this year, like always. I mean, the clubs are working very hard to make it happen on game day. That's the key part of the working with volunteers. So they're doing a really good job, and we've been really happy with the way the competition's going so far.
It seems as though it's getting a lot of outreach as well. A lot of people tweeting about it, a lot of social media activities as well, which is always a positive with the way that social media can grab so many people these days.
Well, certainly that has been a key initiative for the Amazons over the last couple of years, is our digital presence. When you look at our demographics, we have a lot of men aged between 18 and 35 that are in this space. So. AFT, certainly the launch of our Waffle app this year. We've had 2,500 people download that app. So that's really, really good to see the communication happening.
One thing that's been talked about a lot has been the standard of footy. And I guess now that the coaches can go back and people can go back and watch the game, courtesy of the AFT show as well, it has been a pretty good standard, hasn't it? Some good footy going around, some great players in the competition. And certainly, as we said, just a good standard to watch.
Yeah, look, I think the amateur footy is how people like to see the game played. And certainly the state game this year against South Australia, the South Australian coach actually said, if you're a football purist, this is the sort of game you want to see. And I think that's really reflected across all our grades.
And what about looking forward, the red armband round coming up? Can you tell us about that initiative?
Well, obviously, as I said, we've had some really good games, but there are some concerns. So red armband day is in conjunction with AFL Multicultural Round. It is really to promote respect. It really is about getting out vilification and abuse of umpires. So it's a real focus for our players on that.
Certainly a great round and a great initiative. Well, Dave, it's been a good season so far. I'm sure it's only going to get better as we finish. And thank you for having us and coming to speak to us.
Thank you very much.
Well, match of the round on the weekend. Let's hope it's not as wet and blustery it is behind us at the moment. What game are we going to have a look at this weekend, Dave?
This week we're heading up the hills. Adam Swanath taking on Kalamunda. You talked about Swanath, and I suggested they might get spanked on the weekend, so hopefully that fires them up. But yeah, we're heading up there. First time we've been up there. Taking on Kalamunda, up and down a bit. Hopefully they can put in a good showing.
Yeah, it should be a really good match, and you can see the links there on the screen. Well, Dave, episode 11 of AFT, done, completed.
We didn't get blown away.
No, always a positive. Nice to be here from Paterson Stadium as well. We'll be back next week again, looking at all the big results from the weekend.